Good morning. Welcome to operating system class. So in today's class, we'll be talking about data reliability, how data is going to be taken up, and how data is going to be organized, and how data is going to be produced to the end user. So these are the primary focuses where data redundancy might a data reliability is going to be taken up. So when we are going to call it as a reliable, obviously we expect that there should not be any loss of data. When we are going to mean that it is a reliability concept, then we will assure that there won't be any loss of data at that time. We are going to assume that content as data reliable. Fine. So the data what we take, there should not be any loss in it. Then we say it is reliable. But now the question was, data was in blocks, data was in file control blocks, and this file control blocks, they are going to be part of the secondary storage memory. They are going to be part of secondary storage memory, and they have to be brought for execution into the primary. Now, how are the data blocks linked from secondary memory to the primary? How is the data block linked from secondary memory to the primary memory was the main focus of bringing this data reliability. And when we are going to bring the contents into the primary memory, we expect that there is zero loss. So for that, they have built a technique, and the name of a technique was redundant array of inexpensive disks. And the name of a technique was redundant array of inexpensive disks. So in this redundancy array of inexpensive disks, in short, we are going to call them as RAID levels. In short, we are going to call them as RAID levels. So redundancy array of inexpensive disk is a way which is representing a secondary storage device, how data is going to be taken up for executing towards the primary. Fine. So now the very first level, we are going to call it as RAID 0 level. The very first level, we will be calling it as RAID 0 level. So in RAID 0 level, the primary focus was to go with the data stripping. The primary level was to go with the data stripping. So what is data stripping means? Data bits are going to be partitioned across multiple disks. Data bits are going to be partitioned across multiple disks. So I am going to have a disk 1 followed by disk 2. So I have some A1, A2, A3, A4. Similarly, B1, B2, B3, B4. So what I am going to interpret? Now, RAID level 0, it is going to talk that A1, A2, A3, A4, there are 4 bits, and these 4 bits, they are tripped over 2 multiple disks. They are going to be tripped over 2 multiple disks. So that was the concept of taking RAID 0. Next one was RAID 1. The next level will be the RAID 1 content. So in this RAID 1 content, the main intention was towards going mirroring. The next one was towards going mirroring concept. When we are going to say a mirroring concept, the same content of data is going to be taken up in the second device also. When we are going to take up mirroring concept. Whatever bits we are going to bring it in one disk, the same bits are going to be placed in another bits, so that if one copy is lost, ultimately another copy can sustain. If one copy is going to be lost, another copy is going to be sustained. So that is the primary intention of taking up the mirroring concept. So in mirroring concept, one copy which was in the disk, the same copy is going to be taken up in the another disk. Then such atmosphere, we are going to call it as some mirroring concept. And this mirroring concept was implemented in RAID 1 level. That means, if I am going to call it as RAID 1, now I can say that whatever bits are going to be there, I can call A1, A2, B1, B2 here. The same techniques are going to be in the other copy of the disk. The same bits are going to be as the other copy in the bits. So that is where we are going to call the item as mirroring here. So RAID 1, I am going to have A1, A2 as bits. So the same copy is going to be in the other disk. So I can call these items as some disk 1 and disk 2. So whatever items are going to be in disk 1, the same items are going to be in this level. We are going to call that one as mirroring concept. Fine. Now let us skip 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then before we that, we can see these two observed, two words, RAID 0 plus 1, RAID 1 plus 0, right? After 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there are two more terms, RAID 0 plus 1 and RAID 1 plus 0. So now you should have a glimpse. How is this RAID 0 plus 1 work? That means RAID 0 plus 1, it is going to be a combination of stripping and it is going to be a combination of mirroring. But what is RAID 1 plus 0? If it is 1 plus 0, then it is a combination of mirroring and data stripping, right? So when one concept, it is stripping plus mirroring, which it is going to be organized in parallelized, and in another concept, it is going to be taken up with mirroring followed by data stripping. So these are the four major aspects which are going to be in this RAID level. So let us look at the architecture called as RAID 0 plus 1. Let us look into the architecture called as RAID 0 plus 1. So RAID 0 plus 1, what it is going to take up first? It is going to be illustrated with a disk. It is going to be illustrated with a disk, and this is a disk. It is going to have some bit blocks A1, A2. It is going to have a disk blocks called as A1, A2. So A1, A2, A1, B2, C1 and C2. 5 bits are going to be stripped, right? A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2. Then it is going to obey stripping. Then what it should do? It should go with level 1. It should go with level 1. What is level 1? It has to go with mirroring. That means again it is going to display A1, A2, followed by B1, B2, C1, C2. Right? So it is a unification approach which it is going to bring up both data stripping and mirroring. So in data stripping, I am going to have 4 bits, two bits are one disk, two bits are another disk. But then I am going to have this mirroring in the two bits are going to have its mirror copy in the other disk. So now this 0 plus 1, it is going to unify, that is RAID 0.
it is going to unify RAID 0 and it is going to unify the architecture called as RAID 1. So, A1A2 is going to apply for the stripping concept. A1A2 same copy is going to be done in another approach. So, that is where this 0 and 1 is going to come into picture. Later on, we have 1 plus 0 architecture. The next one was to take up 1 plus 0 architecture. Now, what will happen if it is 1 plus 0? So, RAID 1 plus 0 architecture. In this RAID 1 plus 0 architecture, now it is going to put some RAID 1 and it is going to put some RAID 0 here. So, when I am going to call it as RAID 1, so I am going to have A1, B1 and C1. So, mirroring should happen, right? Now, this time it is 1 plus 0. Now, first mirroring should happen, later on data stripping should happen, right? Earlier, first data stripping went, then it went for mirroring. But in this concept, first mirroring is going to happen, after mirroring is going to happen, then data stripping is going to come into picture. So, A1A, B1, C1 followed by mirroring. So, same bits are going to be taken. So, A1, B1 and C1. Now, data stripping has to take up. So, same sets, it is going to be happen. So, A1, B1, A2, B2, B2, C2, C2. Now you should get the sense, right? Here I am going to write A1, A2, A1, A2. But what here I am going to write? I am going to write A1, A1, A2, A2. You should understand the difference. Here I am going to write A1, A1, A2, A2. Where I am going to write? I am going to write it for 1 plus 0. What I am going to write for 0 plus 1? I am going to write A1, A2, A1, A2. So, if I am going to write this model A1 comma A2 followed by A1 comma A2, then it is going to be implemented with the RAID level called as 0 plus 1. If the same bits are going to be represented with 1 plus 0 architecture, if the same bits are going to be represented with 1 plus 0 architecture, then it is going to be said that 1 plus 0, A1, A1 followed by A2, A2, right? So now you should understand the architectural differences. It is A1, A1, A2, A2. It is A1, A2, again A1, A2. So the difference is going to be purely illustrated either for data stripping, nor it is going to be implemented for data mirroring, right? So these are the four items which are going to be associated with RAID 0, RAID 1, RAID 0 plus 1 and RAID 1 plus 0. Okay, fine. So, after that, now we have to take up what is RAID level 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 in detail. So, before we are going to enter into the RAID level 2, here we should have a glimpse of Hamming code. And this Hamming code, it is going to be part and parcel of parity bit. And parity bit, it is going to be of two types. One, we are going to call it as an even parity. And others we are going to call it as odd parity, right? If I am going to have 1, 1, 1 and I am going to have some error correction and detection code. So for the parity bit, and assume if I am going to take up an even parity, you should see that to make all numbers as even. So in this case, I am going to call 3 ones are there across 3 disks. Now the fourth disk I am going to implement it as 1. If the same thing I am going to do here, and if I am going to use a concept called as odd parity here, now in this odd parity I will make that it should happen with odd number of ones. Odd number of ones has to happen. So there are
zero.
I am going to put this value as 0 again, right? So the Hamming distance it is going to take up, it is going to work with the even parity or an odd parity bits, and these odd parity bits they are going to be spread across multiple disks along with the original data. So I have a original data here, and along with this original data I do have some associated contents which are going to be called as some parity bits. So parity bits are also going to be for checking of error detection or error correction during the transmission. So there is a source computer, and it has to, the data has to be moved from source computer to destination computer. There at that time we need to supply a error detection and correction codes so that no bugs, no errors are going to happen when data is going to be moved from source to destination. For that we are going to use error detection and error correction codes, and there we use a technique called as Hamming code, Hamming distance. At that time we are going to associate a parity bit so that if there is change in the disk pattern, obviously it affects Hamming code. Once Hamming distance with this correction code has been affected, it shows that the transmission is going to have some error, right? So any of a bit has been changed, then it is going to be interpreted that there is some change in the value and the accurate data has not been received to the destination. So that is how a Hamming distance is going to play up across. Fine. Now the second level rate, the second level rate is going to be implemented across multiple disks. So I can call it as disk 1, disk 2, followed by disk 3 and disk 4. So these are going to hold the data bits which are going to happen with data security. Data is going to be distributed across multiple disks, and it is going to have some error correction codes. So here the parity bit is going to be associated. So I am going to have some A1, A2, A3 and A4 bits here. Then I am going to have parity bits. Then we are going to have a parity bit at that time. Then that is the situations we are going to call here as a RAID 2 content. Okay, so in RAID 2 content, the data is going to be stripped across multiple partitions. Data is going to be stripped across multiple partitions. If I am going to have A, it is combination of some A1, A2, A3 and A4. It is combination of A1, A2, A3 and A4. And for that we are going to raise a parity bit. And this parity bit is going to be spread up with the error indication and correction codes. So for that we are going to use this Hamming code, and these Hamming codes they are represented with parity bits and as a part of ECC. So that is how a RAID 2 level is going to be illustrated. After RAID 2 is done, after RAID 2 is going to be done, next one will be the RAID 3 architecture. Next one will be the RAID 3 architecture. So in this RAID 3 architecture, in this RAID 3 architecture, we have data scripting and thereby we have parity. That means A1, A2, A3 followed by B1, B2 and B3. Now we have a parity bit called as AP, then we have this item called as parity bit here. Similarly, if I'm going to use the values called as A4, A5 and A6. So at this case, it is parity bit 1 to 3 and these are going to be parity bits from 4 to 6. Similarly, if I am going to have another bit called as B1, B2 and B3, for these three bits, we are going to associate a parity bit for 1 to 3, right? So, data stripping is going to be possible in this RAID 3 level, okay? A1, A2, A3, parity bit is constituted. A4, A5, A6, parity bit is going to be constituted. B1, B2, B3, parity bit is going to be consumed. In this way, we are going to consume for a single row, for a single block there. Then we are going to assume that concept as RAID 4 level, RAID 3 level. So in RAID 3, we have an association of data stripping here. And for this data stripping, we are going to associate a parity bit. So, first three, they are going to be representing the data part and the next one, it is going to be representing with the parity bit part. So, this is regarding RAID 3. Next comes the level called as RAID 4. Next comes the level called as RAID 4. So, in this RAID 4 architecture, now, the content was as follows. So here we are going to have data blocks. And for this data block, parity is going to be done with the XOR operation. Parity bit is going to be taken up with the XOR operation. So that was the key mode. What this RAID 4 is going to be talking about. So I am going to have some A1, A2 and A3. Then B1, B2 and B3. Now, for the entire A, I have a parity bit. For the entire B, I am going to have a parity bit. So I make an XOR operation with A1, A2 and A3. Then I am going to get this parity bit. So you should understand one more difference here. When coming to RAID 3 architecture, A1, A2, A3, fourth bit was spread down, right? A1, A2, A3, fourth bit is going to be spread down here. But when coming to this RAID 4 architecture, at this case, we should understand that these two blocks are going to be considered. A block, B block, and another A block, and A block is going to be spread. Now, all this parity bit is going to be computed at the other end. And how is the parity bit generated? It is going to be using up this XOR operation. It is going to be using up the XOR operation at this case. So, the difference you should understand between RAID 3 and the difference between RAID 4, we should understand. As far as RAID 3 is going to be concerned, it is going to be stripping the bits as many bits are going to be there. But when coming to this block, we have block A1, block A2, block A3. For this entire block, we are going to generate a parity. So here you can understand it is a limitation. Here you can understand there is a repetition of a block, but as far as the RAID 4 is going to be concerned, there is no repetition. So that you should understand as a part of RAID 4 architectures. There you should understand it is part of the RAID 4 architectures. Fine. After RAID 4 is going to be considered, next we do have RAID 5 and RAID 6 architectures. So next we are going to talk about RAID 5 architecture and RAID 6 architecture. So in RAID 5 architecture, parity bit is distributed across multiple disks. That was the keynote as far as RAID 5 is going to be taken up. In RAID 5, in RAID 1, 2, 3, 4, the common thing was always parity bit as the fourth position, right? In RAID level 2, in RAID level 3, in RAID level 4, what was the commonality was the parity bit, it is always at the fourth level. So it is not coming at the first position, it is not coming at second, or it is not distributed across third. So that was the data is going to be fixed towards the fourth position. Now a distributed mechanism was handled towards the parity, and parity is also going to be moved across multiple disks. So how was this architecture shown was? So we have block A, block A1, block A2, block A3, and we are going to write parity, right? Now I have block B1 followed by block B2, and block parity is going to be taken up to the third disk, and B3 is going to be moved into the fourth disk. And here you can see another interleaving where C1 was at the root position. Parity bit is now switching towards the second disk. Thereby, we are going to have C2 and C3. So that is how you have to understand the entity. Okay. So in the first case, A1, A2, A3, parity bit was static. Now parity bit is going to be distributed towards the multiple disks. How it is going to be distributed? In case 2, you can see that parity was moved towards the disk 3. It is parity was always at the 4. Now it is going to be moved to disk 3. Now you can see that the parity bit is going to be moved to disk 2. Now the parity bit is now moved to disk 2. And assume there is some D1 here, then I can say parity bit is moved to first, then I can say it is D1, D2 and D3. So there are disk blocks which are going to be spread across, and further we are going to put this parity aspects here. So that is how the concept of RAID 5 is going to be taken up. After RAID 5 is going to be taken up, the next element will be the RAID 6 architecture. The next level will be the RAID 6 architecture. So in this RAID 6 architecture, what it is going to be assumed was, we have extra parity bit to tolerate failure, right? If there is a mismatch, if there is a failure of bits, parity bit is going to come into picture, see that data is not lost. That was the concept which it was taken up right from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0 plus 1 and 1 plus 2. For all the things, commonality was there should not be any data loss. That is data reliability. Now the question was, what if parity bit is going to loss? Now the question was, what if parity bit is going to loss? Who is going to have the backup of parity bit? The next question was, who is going to have the backup for parity bit? So A1, A2, A3, if there is a loss in there, you go and collect the data from the parity bit, which is always with hamming code. Now, the question was, if That means A1, A2, A3 are going to be dependent on the parity. So parity will rescue an operation if there is some mismatch in these three bits. Now the question was, if there was some error prone, if there was some error prone, if there was a tolerance of failure at the parity bit, then where is the backup for parity bit? So that question has arrived. So for that, the RAID 6 level is going to come into picture to address this scenario. So in RAID 6, what it is going to happen was, there is one more parity bit. There is one more parity bit, and this parity bit is a backup for another parity bit. It's a backup for the existing parity bit. That means we have two parity bits, parity P and parity Q. Parity Q, it is going to be a backup for parity P. So at this case, we are going to draw 5 disks rather than 3 disks. We are going to draw 5 disks rather than 3 disks. And remember, parity is now distributed across multiple pins. That means I am going to have A1, A2 and A3. Now I will be rating it as A3, which is the scenario, and I am going to get this Q. So we are going to call Q as an extra parity. We are going to call Q, we are going to call it as an extra parity. As far as P is going to be concerned, it is a general parity. As far as P is going to be concerned, it is going to assume as a general parity bit. But then we are going to call it as Q. Q is going to be considered as extra parity bit. So next we do now V1, V2, V3. We will be having spreading of content size. So it is VP, that is first parity bit. Then we are going to have VQ, it is second parity bit. So V1, V2, which is missing. Now we are going to add the general attribute, that is V3. Similarly, if I am going to have a disk block called as C1, then it is C1 followed by C parity, C extra parity, followed by the general bits of C. Followed by the general bits of C. Assume it is for D. So it is D1, it is D3, followed by DQ. Then we are going to call D1, D2, and D3. Right? So we are going to be assumed with the contents. That is, DP is going to be a general parity, DQ is going to be an extra parity, G1, D2, D3 are the core elements of the data types. Right? This is all regarding the data reliability. So this is all regarding data reliability. So the most important concepts will be the directory systems, the disk management, and write levels as far as this unit is going to be concerned. So reliability, the primary focus was there should not be any loss of data. To see that there is no loss of data, we are going to add one more bit called as parity bit. And if once parity bit is going to be happen, how can I manage the things? I can manage with redundancy, inexpensive array of inexpensive disk, where the short form we are going to call it as RAID. And this RAID is going to be organized in level 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and it is going to be organized with 0 plus 1 and 1 plus 0. So that is how the primary focus of the RAID levels is going to be. So that is all for today. Thank you for joining.